Which year?
Good morning.
Nice to see you. Have a day. Do all of you please sit down.
Pleasant.
I know that there's going to be a wave of crescent hours that aren't coming here in a second, so we can't get into any deep subject that maybe we could pick up a little minute or two. And I'd like to know who's here, a little introduction for us.
I think that's a terrific idea. Why don't we, you know who I am, so what do you say we move right to the right here?
I'm Susan Sarvis from Manchester, New Hampshire. I have a manufacturing company.
Malcolm McKillop, Pacific Edison Manufacturing Company, California.
And I'm here as my, in my capacity as chairman of the Interagency Committee on Women's Business Enterprise.
I'm Beth Rogers from Redwood, California, and Mike Abrams is going to tell you he's going to get a report on lunch. He wants a report on lunch.
I have an answer to that. Mike Abrams is a muscle builder.
And I'm here as your special assistant for business liaison.
And I'm Bob McMillan from New York with Avon Products.
And I'm Ruth Carr from Memphis, Tennessee. So, yes.
And I'm Steve Transcript. This is a California. And I teach you at construction.
You're going home. Wait till I get my hair.
The president will be bringing back today's report pretty soon with the SBA.
And I'm Evelyn Everett, teacher Chicago, president of International Travel, and I learned most of my entrepreneurship from your mother-in-law.
I believe that.
I'm Don Schreiber from New York, the former chairman of Jason Trent Company.
I'm Roger Spearman, I'm SBA's representative on the committee.
And I'm Claire Giordano from Wyandotte, Michigan.
Corlene Cathcart from Northwest Wyoming, Cody. Several small businesses, one in healthcare.
Helen Sanchez-Sotelo from Dallas, Texas, and I have a consulting firm there.
I'm Mailey Tom from your old stomping grounds. I'm the Chief Administrative Officer of the California State Assembly.
And I'm Jane Hales from Atlanta. I'm a general contractor.
Lights, please.
Anything else you'd like to
do? I came in to listen.
Thank you.
What's up, friends? How's it going? I'm doing
well. We know what you're doing all the time, man. Thank you.
Wonderful
to see you. My favorite son of Palisades. We've lived in the Palisades so long, we hated to miss you.
What's that, Doc?
Hey, how you doing?
Hey, what brings you here?
Jim, we stayed over to see you. No, I did a thing for the Smithsonian Institute.
Oh, yes, of course, that's right. Yes. Yeah.
And we're staying an extra day just because we want to see you.
We want to see you. It was such a pleasure, and when we were allowed to see you, we thought, well, we got to stay.
Oh, listen, well, that's wonderful.
Do you remember that Brentwood Boys and Girls Club?
Yes.
That was before you were even governor.
Yeah, oh my goodness. Yeah.
And I can't think of any other fellow that was with us.
How can he
use
so many people over
the years? He's an Italian boy, or whatever.
It's been 100 years.
Anyway, we got a few laughs off him.
Thank you, Brian. That was good.
And thanks a million for the telegrams and for the wonderful things that you sent for me. You have to know more about me than I did.
We know you're busy. You want to get going.
Yeah,
Nancy's
sure.
And Camp David, and give her regards.
Well, it'll be a pleasure. And lots of good luck. And
just a couple of those souvenirs.
Oh, nice. Oh, Burgess is such an honor.
That's beautiful.
He's such an honor to work.
Thanks.
Okay.
Good luck to you. Good for you, believe me. And we'll see. Thank
Goodbye.
You.
Bye-bye.
Yes, sir.
Dick Cartwright, Mr. President. I'm George Clark, Sleeman and Liaison.
Good pleasure to meet you, sir.
Mr. President, it's a pleasure to meet you again.
Yes, pleasure to meet you.
Yes.
Come behind the desk for a letter for you.
Okay. Well, thank you very much. Thank you.
Mr. President, Tom Conley, the Elevator Instructors Union. Well, come forward.
Good to meet you. Mr. President Steinfeld, George Shaver.
Yes,
pleased to meet you. Nice to see you.
Hello, Mr. President. Jeff Massey from the Engineers, New York City. Good to see you, Jeff. Good to see you.
Hi, Dan Landon from the Mason Technical
District.
Yes.
President, John Lightham from New York City.
Good to see you. Mr. President, Jim Cooper from the Sunset.
Hi, Mr. President. John Bird, standing up, ready to meet you, sir.
Good to see you, Dan.
Thank you, Mr. President. Pleased to meet you, Mr. President. Charles Ferguson from the faculty. And thanks a lot for putting this country back on the map.
Thank you very much.
Joe Blaine, Marvel Chief, as well as I said. God bless you, Mr. President.
Thank you.
Great pleasure, Mr. President. Charlie Hill, Pat Hunter, located in New York.
John Powers, Marvel Carver Scholars in Sutter's, New York. Well, good to see you, Dan.
Good to see you.
Thank you.
Welcome to the
Hi, Mr. President. Nice to see you. How are you doing? Thanks for having us down here. This is Fred Devine, Mr. President, the gentleman that had a conference group together.
Nice to see you on behalf of the construction trade unions in New York City. We'd like to present
Mr. Navarro Manningham.
We are in Washington. We were going to have
thank you.
Could you hold for just one second? I have a specific request, Mr. President, to have this shot.
Answer the roof. Are we going?
My coming here to appear before the Ways and Means Committee, plumping for a tax reform. I'm sad I've heard long ago. I got here and there were some fellows from the AFL-CIO office. Our unions were all in the Federation. And they showed me a book that was their tax policy. It was directly opposite where I was here. I remember asking at the time, I said, well, wait a minute. No one ever spoke to us about this. You represent a lot. There's, who knows about that, this other plan? Any answers? No, I've always thought that the people you represent and I represented, they step into that voting booth, they could do what the hell they want to do.
That's right. Mr. President, we certainly appreciate that. Letting us in, especially into the Oval Office. We know there haven't been too many labor leaders lately in the Oval Office. God bless you, Mr. President. We're with you. And we are much better off than 4 years ago. Thank you very much, Mr. President.
Thank you.
We certainly hope so.
We certainly hope so.
Mr. President.
He was one night here as a guest. They put him in the to sleep in there. And he could not bring himself to sleep. So he spent the night in this little settee. Well, Lincoln had sat in the little settee alone.
As much as he
never slept in that bed. Because the day his wife was having me. And it arrived after the shot. So he never was in it. I always get a kick out of thinking about that uncomfortable night that he spent.
That's true.
Well, we almost slept on the floor to get the thing done.
Well, that's what I'm going to take another look at that.
By the President, well, that was the original.
Take care of yourself here. We need you.
Mr. President.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
That was the original one. Teddy Roosevelt. And his phone removed it and sent it to his library in Missouri.
Thank you.
And he put in
thank you.
Green. Like white antique green. And she came into the White House, she painted it white. And then she went to the original black and she printed the original. So I got the assignment in New York to replace it. I had been the original. And she loved it better than the original. Of course, we paid here. And the stone was from Vermont.
And 20 years ago, that was
1963.
Yeah.
He was assassinated shortly after. That was in June.
God bless you, Your Honor, sir.
Thanks.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you.